Hi, I'm Chris Anderson. This is Makercise. In this episode, I make the protractor disc for the Shaper project. The first step is I've got to cut this piece of rod stock in half because I need an arbor to cast this protractor disc on. Once I've cast the protractor disc on the arbor, I can mount it between centers and turn the outside of the protractor disc, drive the arbor out, and then mount that on the Shaper. The reason I need two arbors is I don't expect the first arbor that I use for the protractor disc to emerge unscathed. Typically, I have to cut it, drill it out, and then hammer out the arbor. The book indicates that you can coat it with soot from a candle and that will be sufficient to lubricate the arbor so that you can drive it out. I have not had good luck with that. It might be something I'm doing wrong. If you feel like you know the answer, put it in the comments. I'd be interested to hear your thoughts, but I expect to need two arbors.
One of the things I need to get a little better at is getting a good center, right, you know, in the center of a piece of rod stock. That way I'm not spending so much time machining down a pretty well perfect cylinder into a smaller perfect cylinder. So look for that in an upcoming video.
I move the tailstock up just a hair. And that way I can make the end of the arbor slightly smaller than this middle point here. I'm going to go through using some silicon carbide abrasive paper to kind of smooth out the finish on this, try to polish it up to where it'll maximize the chances that this arbor will extract from the pattern. And then after I'm done, I'll kind of see where I want to position the pattern on this arbor. And that way the diameter is pretty close to what I want, whether it's a little bit bigger or a little bit tighter. I think I can vary that based on where I position it on this arbor. And it's plenty long, so I should be able to face up either side of the protractor disc as well as extracted off the end of the arbor. This is 7.865 on this end and 7.850 on this end, so roughly 1.5 thousandths larger on this end than on this end. Hopefully that'll allow the protractor to slide off readily. I would have liked this to have been a little bit smoother and more polished, but I think I took off a little bit too much on the very last pass. I didn't get to do a spring pass to get this all nice and cleaned up. Instead, I just kind of sanded it down. But anyway, we'll see if this is enough. There are very slight little undulations in the surface, so that might be enough to cause the protractor disc to hang up, but we'll find out.
I really am getting to be quite the fan of lost foam casting. I mean, it's so much superior to making wooden patterns, especially for a project like these Gingery machines. If you're making a lot of parts, it makes sense to invest in a mold that you can reuse in greensand. However, if you're doing one-off castings, it seems to me superior because you make a pattern that then you cast, and really you don't have to deal with extracting that pattern from your greensand mold. That's the big advantage, and I really like the tolerances that I get when using lost foam. Another advantage of this lost foam method is that you can put the pattern right on the arbor, and then you don't have to embed the arbor in a greensand mold and risk damaging it. It just goes right in with the pattern. Like I mentioned earlier, I did put soot on this arbor prior to casting it, and I've noticed in the past that the soot will kind of rub off if you brush up against it, and with me needing to insert this into the polystyrene pattern, I knew that would be a problem, so I just used some hairspray to kind of fix it into place, and that seemed to keep it from rubbing off when I inserted it into the pattern. I used hot glue to kind of form a little bit of a fillet around the arbor. And then I mixed up some refractory. I used plaster of Paris. I like it because it seems to dry quicker. But I pretty much just coat the entire polystyrene pattern with the exception of the very top of the pour cup. I let the plaster of Paris dry overnight, and then I proceeded with embedding it in sand. And I keep my Lost Foam sand kind of separate and together because it really smells bad after casting apart. That's from the residual byproducts that get absorbed into the sand. And I could burn those off, but for now it's just a little easier to keep it separated.
Pretty happy with the way this turned out, and one of the things that I did is I've been reading up on lost foam casting, and really what you want is kind of a smooth flow to fill the mold. I didn't leave any vent holes or anything like that on account of polystyrene should just decompose into gas and liquid byproducts that then get absorbed by the refractory investment that you put on the outside of the pattern. In this case, it's plaster of Paris. I need to turn it down, clean it up, you know, cut off the sprue, cut off this little piece that I put on top to catch any kind of floating byproducts. I had a solid pour cup instead of the, you know, styrofoam cups that I've been using. I just felt like they kind of collapsed in on themselves. As the metal melts through it, the metal pressure keeps the sand from kind of falling in, and that's what I feel like I was having problems with when I used the styrofoam pour cups.
Like I mentioned earlier, after I cast the protractor onto this arbor, I used the centers that were already in the arbor to mount it in the lathe between centers. I then was able to turn down the outside diameter as well as face off both sides of the protractor disc. And these faces should be perpendicular to that arbor, so they should mate well with the front of the ram.
I'm going to try to use this wheel puller to pull this off. Yeah!
The book indicates to use a 6-inch flexible steel rule with 1/32 inch divisions, and then turning the diameter of the protractor disc so that those 1/32 inch divisions make 1 degree. That's 1980s talk. So I used Adobe Illustrator and made my own custom graduations based on the actual measured diameter of the protractor disc. I'll need to mount the protractor disc to the ram.
But I'm gonna wait to do that until after I have the rotating head kind of a little farther along. I don't want to go make any permanent modifications until I really can tell how everything is going to fit together. I was really happy with being able to cast on this arbor as well as being able to drive it out. I didn't think I would be able to drive it out, but it was. I'm happy with the fit of this part. It's doing a good job just having an air seal there with my hand. So in the next step, I'll be pretty much repeating this process, but for the rotating head that goes on the front of the ram. I hope this project builds your confidence to exercise your inner maker. Thanks for watching.